read the fifth chapter, verses 6 through 12. And when you have it, will you do me a favor and shout, I got it? Will you do me that favor and shout, I got it? Should I use the chords?
Yeah, you know.
I got it. Let me know you are with me. Job, the fifth chapter, verses 6 through 12, and I'm going to skip around in that to bring out what God has given me. Verse 6 reads, although affliction cometh not forth of the dust, neither do trouble spring out of the ground. Verse 7 says, yet man is born unto trouble, as the sparks fly upward. Verse 8 says, I would seek unto God would I commit my cause, which doeth great things and unsearchable, marvelous things without numbers. Who giveth rain upon the earth, sendeth waters upon the fields. Verse number 11, to set up on high those that be low. Those which mourn may be exalted to safety. He disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. I want to focus in on verse number 12. To verse number 11, to set up on high those that be low. God, we thank you. We praise you. We lift your name on high. We move Joshua out of the way that something may be said, something may be felt. Bring somebody, draw somebody nearer to Christ to say, what must I do to be saved? Thank you for the pastor. Thank you for the first lady. Thank you for the members. Thank you for those who are watching. Let them be touched, healed, and delivered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I just want to talk to you for a few moments. I want you to tell yourself, I'm set up to soar.
Set up to soar.
Set up to soar. I have been set up to soar. Soar. Soar is a verb in the English dictionary. It means to rise or increase dramatically as in position, status, and value, or in price.
Yeah, yeah.
To excel to majesty, impressive beauty, or dignity, stature. To rise and expire to a higher or more exalted level. How many want to go higher?
Yeah.
Want to go higher. Not just higher in what you are doing, what you intend to accomplish, but higher in the Lord.
Yeah.
10, to go higher. Feel free to shout hallelujah, amen. Even if you're at home, don't let the screen stop you from giving God the praise.
Hallelujah.
I want you to understand that Psalms 149:4 says, for the Lord taketh pleasure in his people.
Yeah.
And he will beautify the meek with salvation. Because we are a chosen generation.
Yeah.
I want you to know, was a quote I looked up, it says, a setback is a setup for a comeback.
Come on, preach up!
Setback is a setup for a comeback. Your time as a caterpillar has expired. Your wings are now ready to soar. I want you to know today you have to refuse to be average, but soar to new heights. Every one of us can absolutely expect to face trouble, to face trials, to face hardships, to face suffering. And most of us know this from my own experience, the longer you live, the more kinds of trouble you are going to face.
Come on, preacher.
Somebody shout hallelujah. I feel good in here. I think the Holy Ghost is here already. Amen. The longer you live, the more kinds of trouble you are going to face. What Brother Paul tells us in 2 Corinthians, what does he say? We are troubled on every side.
Yes.
Yeah. We are not in distress. We are not perplexed. We are not in despair. We are not persecuted. We are not forsaken. We are not cast down. We are not destroyed. Why? Because we have the armor of the Holy Ghost put on us.
Yeah, yeah.
We can withstand the test. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah again. I notice as I'm looking around, I notice, amen, I look up to our pastor who has retired from the Chicago Police Department. I want you to know I have noticed when troubles come, people normally have the tendency to respond in a way that shows their true colors.
Yeah, yeah.
When trouble comes, when they get into trouble, most people panic.
Yes, sir.
Y'all know what I'm talking about. Most people have, amen, an outrage. Most people have an anxiety attack. Amen. They begin really to doubt God.
Yeah, yeah.
They begin, amen, to question his goodness. I looked in Psalms and it said, truly God has been good to Israel. I want to tell you something, that there's nothing bad about God.
Come on, preach.
God is good when you wake up and he's good when you go to bed. Can somebody shout, he's good? Learn to rejoice. It was Brother David who said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continue to be in my mouth. I want you to try something this week. When trouble seems to come, I want you to go get to praising God and shouting out, Lord, I thank you, Lord. I appreciate you, because that stray bullet that was going out could have hit my house. Lord, I thank you. My tire could have gone out on my way over there. But just give God a praise and just lift your hands and shout, Lord, I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
For sparing my life. The devil, amen, is trying to steal your joy. He's trying to steal your peace. Amen. God is doing something. He's setting you up for greater. He's setting you up for greater. And I want you to understand, when God has his hands on your life and trouble beseeches you and attempts to destroy your character and kill your dreams and dismantle the ministry that God has given you, it will come and try to cut off your wings and cause you not to soar. You need to look the devil in the face and tell him, get behind me, because I'm on my way to victory. How many are on their way to victory? I want you to understand, as we look in this text today, Job, amen, was being disputed by his friend, or his so-called friend. I want you to know he had came to the conclusion that he had done all resisting sin, but Job had not resisted sin. And that's why, amen, he was having all of these problems, and his friend was far from the truth. I want to encourage you today, amen, and let you know, you can't listen to everybody in your ears, and you can't take advice from everybody. God has given you a pastor. He's given you a leader, amen, his own heart. You should go and hear what the man of God has to say for you. Ain't nobody saying hallelujah to that. Amen. You should go listen to the man of God, what he has to say for your life. Job's friend was confused. He was thinking, amen, that Job had sinned, and we all were born into a sin, shaping into iniquity. iniquity. I want you to know today that all three of Job's friends had made the mistake of assuming. Amen. Job had committed this great sin, and that's why he was suffering. They didn't even have, they didn't even know about the conversation that God had with the devil. Amen. God later had to rebuke his friend for being wrong and giving that advice. But what I want you to know today, that when you are being set up to soar, people are going to disappoint you. Amen. When you are being set up to soar, they may never have your best interest at heart. I want you to know today that God loves you and he knows everything. That's why the scripture says, cast your cares on him. Why? Because he cares. Can somebody shout hallelujah? I'm about to get out of here. I feel like shouting now.
Yeah.